Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's talk about margins in Pages. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Let's start with a word processing document. So here we have our default body text. You can see the cursor blinking in that. And let's say we want to set up specific margins. First, to actually see what the margins are set to, you want to go to the sidebar here, go to Document. Then in the Document area of the sidebar, you could find Document Margins. And you can see here they're set to 1 inch all the way around, top, bottom, left, and right. Now if we want to actually see the margins on the page, we can. We can actually do that one of two ways. The first way is to go to View. And let's show ruler. This will show the ruler here at the top of the page. I'm going to zoom out a little bit to 75%. And you can see here the left and right margins are indicated here on the ruler. They're not actually the margins. These are the indents, but by default they're going to match. I'll talk more about indents in a minute. If we want to see the top and bottom margins as well, we can use View and then Show Layout. And this will show us here a box which is the body text. And the body text is going to be this text field that flows from one page to the next, and it fits perfectly in the margins. So if I were to take the top margin and say decrease it a bit, you can see it changed there. Increase it a bit, it changes there. The same thing with the bottom, the left, and the right. Now we do have the ability to turn on facing pages. And that's when you have like a book or a magazine or a newsletter, and you're going to have page one be the front cover, page two and three face each other, and then even and odd pages facing each other from that point on. If I turn on facing pages, then things change quite a bit. You can see here page one will be by itself. I can insert a page break, and you can see page two, another page break, page three. So you can see how everything after page one are two facing pages. Then the document margins change to have top and bottom like before, but now inside and outside margins. So if I go to pages two and three here, if I change the inside margin, you could see how it changes the right margin on page two and the left margin on page one. This is the inside near the binding for the book. So now let's talk about indents. Indents, which are shown here in the ruler, are where the text actually flows to. So indents work on a paragraph level, not for the entire document. So here I have two paragraphs of text. If I were to change the document margins, like let's change the left side, you can see all the text changes. If I wanted to just change the indent, then I could do so by going to Format and then Layout, and here are the indents. So there's left and right, and you can see that just changes it for the current paragraph. So if I have my cursor in this paragraph, I could change the left indent there. There's also the first line indent, which is separate from the left side of all of the rest of the lines. And you can see here how I could actually just drag the indent here. So while the indent starts at the margins, it doesn't have to stay there. You can have the indent set on a per paragraph level. Now let's change to page layout. You can do that by either turning off the document body here or going to File and then Convert to Page Layout. That's going to get rid of the body text. And now I've got under Document, Header and Footer Margins. And if I were to change these, it's going to change the position of the header and the footer. But what about the margins? Well, with page layout, there are no margins. You could put things wherever you want. So if I put a text box here, I could keep it within a certain space, or I could put it all the way over to the left, even off the page. The same thing to the right or top and bottom. So margins themselves really don't mean anything. You could do whatever you want. If I go back to standard word processing, the same is actually true for individual elements. Whether it's a text box like this, you could see I could put it wherever I want. It's not stuck in between the margins. The same will be true for images or for shapes. I can put them wherever I want. So if the idea is to have a different margin on another page because you want to have a large image, you don't need to actually even use the margins for that. Just place the image where you want. But let's say that you're using page layout and you kind of want to impose margins on yourself. Well, you could do that using guides. So since I've already turned rulers on, and again, you would do that here, I could go ahead and add guides. And there's a menu choice here where you can hide them. So you want to make sure they're not hidden. And what I could do is I could drag over from the left ruler any vertical guide. So say if I wanted to kind of set myself a limit of 1 inch here on the left and maybe 1 inch here on the right. I could drag down from the top for a horizontal line so I could set myself a guide here. And then I could use this to snap items to it, like for instance a text box. You can see how it snaps to it. I don't have to obey it. I can actually move things outside of there. But if I'm self-imposing margins on my document, I can make sure I always fall within these guides. And I could add as many other guides as I want. I could add a center guide. Maybe I can add a guide that's a little bit closer in for some elements or further out for others. I can create as many guides as I need. So on page layout documents, there aren't really any margins. There's just settings that the header and the footer will obey. And margins in a word processing document only really apply to the body text. Any other elements that you want to add can be placed anywhere. And now under Document, Document, you actually have placing for the header and the footer. And these will obey the document margins. And these are independent vertically of the document margins. So I can change the document margin there and you can see the header doesn't move. But they do depend on the left and the right margins. That determines not only the body text, but the width of the header and footer. So I hope that gives you some insight on using margins in Pages. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.